Hi there, Kim Kunkel here from easydigitals.com, Photoshop backgrounds and templates for sports photographers. Today, I want to show you how to customize this brand new Stadium Mirage template set. So when we're finished, it's going to look something like this. So let's go ahead and get started. I'm going to open my file and we're going to start with this Mirage 12x8 Memory Mate. I'm going to click open. Okay, let's go over the layers here. You're going to have text top, and if you click this little triangle, it'll open up the folder and you'll see all of the layers beneath that you can customize. And then you're going to have a second text set, so you can use either one. It's totally up to you. Or you can figure out like information you want to use to put on both of them. You're going to have a place for a other team photo. You're going to have smoke front. You're going to have the silhouette and the text that says your player here, just to show you. You can turn those off because you're not going to need them once you get your player in there. You're going to have smoke behind, which you can turn on and off depending on what your look that you're going for. You have a vignette that you can turn on and off. A light and curve, and a hue saturation so that you can change the color of the background to anything you want. So I double click it and I just can push it through to change it to any color. And I can also increase the saturation and lighten and darken. So I'm going to turn that off. And then we have a simple background. So if you don't want the stadium in your background, you can just use simple stadium, and then you can turn on the hue saturation and you can change the background of that. Okay, so let's go ahead and bring in our athlete file, open, and here's our first photo. And I'm going to drag this out of my desktop. I'm going to make sure over here that I have the right area that I want to put it in. And I want to put it right here. So if I select this layer, it'll go right into the right spot. So I'm just going to drag it in. Now, if you want to, you can change it immediately to a smart object, and that way if you do need to resize it, you won't have any pixelation. So let's say you do it like goes in large or small, then you can just change it to a smart object and then you can press shift and resize to make sure you don't lose the aspect ratio. Let's say it goes in like this. Then you can press Control 0 so that you can see all four corners, and then you can just drag it down. Press Enter. Now I'm going to turn off the silhouette and your player here. So now I have my player in, and I'm going to turn off background simple and turn off my hue saturation. For this example, I am going to use the text top, so I'm going to turn off the text bottom. And I'm going to open this up and start changing the text. So I'm going to select my type tool and let's change the name. So I select it and I'm going to type in Monica. Clark. Now let's say I want to resize this background. You can just grab it and take it over. Or you can expand however you want. Press Enter, and then you can change the number. And you can change the name to make it larger. Let's say that I want her last name larger. So I'm going to drag this out. And you can change the color of the ribbon background. So you're going to select where it says ribbon background here, double click, and you can change it to any color. Let's change it to like a dark color. And then we'll come over to this one and we'll change it to blue. So you could select a color in her uniform and then you can modify it from there. Or you can slide this up and down. So that part was pretty easy. You can change all this information. You can make this larger or smaller. Now, let's go ahead and customize this team photo, and I'll see you in the next video.